anyone is having any questions related to RC integration? No questions. Okay. What is the condition for the RC low pass filter circuit to act as an integrator? Anyone can answer.
Output must be
proportional
to the integration of the input signal.
No, that is what you normally give the name to the circuit as an integrator if its output is proportional to the integration of the input signal. But the condition, your RC low pass filter circuit is going to having merely R and C elements, then what is the condition to ensure
RC
that the circuit is going to
RC equal to 20.
RC is equal to 20 times T, okay, or RC is much greater than capital T. What is that much greater than? How do I understand is, if you choose RC as 20 times capital T, where capital T is the time period of your input periodic waveform, then it is going to act as a true integrator. Okay, that is the, what is the point here. So any other questions? Any other questions? So we have come to know that RC low pass filter circuit is one of the circuit we are likely to study in the linear wave shaping circuits, and we have discussed about RC low pass filter circuit when the input is a step input, a sinusoidal input, a pulse input, square wave input, and a ramp input. That we will be winding up the RC low pass filter circuits so that we can move on to the RC high pass filter circuits. Okay, so in the first unit, linear wave shaping circuits, only two circuits. Right, one is RC low pass filter circuit, another is RC high pass filter circuit. In either of the case, we will be using only four varieties of inputs. One is step input, pulse input, square wave input, and a ramp input. So today we are going to start about a new circuit, that is RC high pass filter circuit. Right? Okay. So this is what is the circuit, which is normally called as RC high pass filter circuit. Unlike the earlier circuit where we are taking the output across the capacitor, here you are taking the output across the resistor. Okay, so when your output voltage is across the resistor, then you are calling it as RC, okay, RC high pass filter circuit. Okay, why you are calling it as RC high pass filter circuit? I know that XC is equal to 1 by SC, okay, and omega is 2 pi f. So J 2 pi F C. Okay. So this equation is more than enough for understanding why this circuit is called as RC high pass filter circuit. Okay. So for example, high frequency, okay, at a high frequency, right? What happens when high frequency, let us say F is equal to infinity? What do you say about XC? Zero. 1 over infinity is zero, so XC is zero. So XC is zero means nothing but your capacitor is going to act as a short circuit. Okay. So when your capacitor is short circuit, what is your output voltage is given by? Same as the input voltage. That means your entire input voltage is passed onto the output side. Okay. So that means in this particular case, your output voltage is same as your input voltage. Okay. So for high frequencies, your output is same as the input. That means your circuit is passing the input signals onto the output side, right? That is because your capacitor reactance is zero. That is, your capacitor is acting as short circuit. At low frequencies, what happens to your XC? XC is infinity. That means your capacitor is going to act as open circuit. Okay. So when your capacitor is open circuit, no current can flow through your R. When no current through your R, what is my output voltage is zero, means my circuit is not passing the low frequencies. My circuit is passing the high frequencies. Okay. So that is why this circuit where you are taking your output voltage across the resistor R is what is called as RC high pass filter circuit. Okay. Frequency response of RC high pass filter circuit. Okay, so when the input is a sinusoidal input, right? Okay. When I apply KVL here, Vi of t is equal to VI of t is equal to VC of t plus VR of t. Okay, voltage across the capacitor plus voltage across the resistor. What is voltage across the capacitor is 1 over C integral over 0 to t I of t dt. Okay, plus I of t into R. Right? So let this be equation 1. Okay, let this be equation 1. V naught of t is equal to VI of t. V naught of t is equal to V naught of t is where you are taking the output voltage across the resistor. So the current that is flowing through the circuit be assumed to be I of t into R is what is your output voltage is. Okay, so let this be equation number 2. Right? So apply Laplace transform on both sides of, okay, x of t Laplace transform is capital X of s. Similarly, VI of t Laplace transform is capital VI of s. Okay, so VI of s is equal to 1 by C into integration Laplace transform is 1 by s into I of s, right? Plus R into I of t Laplace transform is I of s, right? And also for the second equation, applying Laplace transform on both sides, it is given as V naught of s into I of s into R, right? Okay. So what I am interested in is, I am interested in V naught of s by VI of s, okay? Transfer function, okay? Just I have taken I of s common in this equation. So I of s into R plus 1 by s. Okay, so this I of s gets cancelled and we are given with R by R plus 1 by SC. Okay, so this I can write it as SC R by 1 plus SC R. Okay, this is what is the transfer function in the S domain. S is a complex variable, S is equal to J omega, right? So we got expression in terms of S domain. Let me call this as H of S. Transfer function H of S is equal to SCR by 1 plus SCR. Okay. So when I replace my S is equal to J omega and omega is equal to 2 pi F, I can write this in terms of a function of F. Okay. So S is equal to J omega, omega is equal to 2 pi F. So what is that? I can write 2 pi F CR divided by 1 plus S is equal to J omega, omega is 2 pi F CR. Okay, so that is equal to, I am dividing the numerator and the denominator with a term J 2 pi F CR. Then is this okay? Right. So I know that J square is nothing but minus 1. So I can write here minus J square. Right, J gets cancelled. This is nothing but minus J, right? So I am writing like this: 1 by 1 minus J by 2 pi FCR. Okay, this I am writing it as 1 by 1 minus J FL by F. Okay, so look at here carefully. In the denominator, F is there. The denominator, F is there. But in the numerator, FL is there, such that FL has to be 1 by 2 pi into RC. Okay? So what is this FL can be written as? FL can be written as 1 by 2 pi RC. Just like your FH is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC, FL is also equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. What is this FH is called as? FH is called as upper cutoff frequency. Here FL is called as lower cutoff frequency. So I got H of F is equal to 1 by 1 minus J FL by F, where FL is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. Okay, where FL is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. FL is called the lower cutoff frequency. It is called lower cutoff frequency. Right? Is this okay so far? Okay, so our idea is to get the magnitude of this as well as the angle. Okay, to get the magnitude of this as well as the angle. If I denote that with A and the angle theta, just like our RCA low pass filter circuit, then what is my A is given as? A is given as, what is the magnitude of this? Plus minus IY. Okay, so root over X square plus Y square. Okay. And what is the theta is given by? Tan inverse of by F. Okay. A plus JB, theta is given by tan inverse of B by A. Here B is minus FL by F. A is 1. So tan inverse of minus FL by F, when it goes to the numerator, it is plus tan inverse of FL by F. Okay. So we got now what is A and what is theta. Okay. Just like the earlier case, I can consider 5 different cases of frequency and I'll try to obtain what is my gain and what is the angle, right? Okay. Right. So let us consider F is equal to 0, F is less than FL, and F is equal to FL, and F is greater than FL, and F is equal to infinity. What is my gain is given by, and what is my theta is given? Gain is given by when F is 0. When F is 0, 1 over 0 is infinity, 1 by infinity is 0, so my gain is 0. Okay, you know that this is primarily a high pass filter circuit. When it is a low frequency, gain has to be 0. Okay, and what is my theta is given by? When F is 0, it is nothing but infinity. Tan inverse infinity is 90 degrees. Okay. And let us consider up to F is less than FL, okay? Or in other words, FL by F is greater than 1. When FL by F is greater than 1, this term is greater than 1. And when the square of that is automatically greater than 1, when 1 is divided by a number greater than 1, this will automatically less than 1. When my gain is less than 1, it is in other words, V out is less than VI, okay? V out is less than VI. Right? Okay. Then what is my theta is going to be? My theta is going to be, what happens when F is equal to FL? It is 45. So that means at most it can be greater than this 90 degrees and less than this 45 degrees. Okay? Right? So it is going to decrement from the 90 degrees and it can go up to only 45 degrees because my FA is less than FL. Okay? Right. Exactly when F is equal to FL, my A is given as 1 by root 2. Okay. Then my theta is given as 45 degrees. Exactly at F is equal to FL, my theta is going to be 45 degrees. When F is greater than FL, so when FL by FL is, when FL by F is much less than 1, this can be neglected. When this is neglected, my gain is equal to be 1. Okay. Then my output is equal to input. You look at here. When your F is greater than FL, higher frequencies denoted by your FL, then your gain is 1. That means your output is same as the input. Okay. Your circuit is acting as a high pass filter circuit. Okay. Yes or no? Okay. Exactly at F is equal to infinity, again it is approximately close to 1. So that means your V0 by VI is again going to be very close to 1. Right, and my theta is going to be 0 degrees. So for these different values of gain and different values of theta, we can plot the magnitude response and the phase response. Okay, response is on x-axis it is frequency, on y-axis it is gain. Okay, on y-axis it is gain, right? And it is going to look something like this. So assume that this is 1, okay, then at some frequency, which is 1 by root 2 times the 1, then your frequency is denoted by FL, okay, and you know that this frequency is, what is that you are calling it as, cutoff frequency or the 3 dB frequency, frequency at which the gain is 1 over root 2 times the maximum gain, okay. This is what is normally a magnitude response is. We have already seen earlier with respect to RC low pass filter circuit. Okay, this is RC high pass filter circuit. Right, magnitude response. Similarly, for phase response, how it is going to look like? This is my f, where my x-axis is going to be theta. Okay, when f is equal to 0, what is my theta is 90 degrees. And as I was moving along the x-axis, that is along the frequency axis, then my angle is going to be reduced. But exactly at f is equal to fh, my angle is found to be, okay, 45 degrees. Okay, this is going to be 45 degrees. And it is going to be zero only at f is equal to infinity. So that is why I have not touched these two lines. Okay, and this particular frequency is what is called as FL, at which my theta is going to be 45 degrees, at which my gain is going to be 1 by root 2 times the maximum gain. Your gain is found to be remaining constant or at least equal to 1 over root 2 times the maximum value, or 70% of your gain is found only after F is equal to FL. So that means from FL to infinity, your gain is normally expected to be 1 over root 2 times. At f is equal to infinity, it is going to reach this 1. Okay, so what is your bandwidth is infinity. The upper limit is infinity, so your bandwidth is infinity. Your RC low pass filter bandwidth is what? Fh only. Okay, because beyond fh, your gain starts reducing. But here, beyond fl, your gain starts increasing. Yes or no? Beyond fl, your gain starts increasing. But after up to fh, your gain is very nominal and it has not reached even 1 by 3 maximum. Only after FL, then only your gain has reached this maximum of 1 by root 2 times, and then it has tried to remain constant. Okay, so the bandwidth in this case is infinity. Very important. Okay, bandwidth in this case is infinity. Right, in the earlier case it is FH, now it is infinity. Right. So from the definition of bandwidth, you can understand that why it is infinite. Okay, from here onwards, all the range of frequencies, your gain is going to be maximum, that is 1 over root 2 times. Right? Okay. When a sinusoidal signal is applied to this, okay, let me write here sine omega t, Vm sine omega t. Okay, when the input is Vm sine omega t, what is my output is going to be? Your output may be A sine, some gain is introduced. Okay, so A sine omega t plus theta. Okay, so that means a gain has increased, and also there is some phase shift that is introduced. Okay, right. So when the input is a sinusoidal input, there is no surprise to us that the output is also a sinusoidal signal, except that there is some gain as well as some phase shift that is introduced. But we are not interested in applying the sinusoidal waveform, but we are interested in altering the shape of the input signal, which is a non-sinusoidal input. Okay, what are all the non-sinusoidal inputs? Step input, pulse input, square wave input, ramp input, exponential input, and so on. Right, so we are interested in applying those kind of non-sinusoidal signals as here to the RC high pass filter circuit. Then we are interested in finding how does the output is going to vary for the given input signal. Okay, so from here onwards, we are going to consider this particular circuit, and we are likely to apply the input as, one time it is step input, we will be finding the output. Another time it is pulse input, we will be finding the output. Another time it is square wave input and a ramp input, and we will find the respective outputs here. Okay, so that is what our target is for the next classes onwards. Okay.